another one. Another one.
We the best music. DJ Khaled.
I don't know if you could take it.
Hi, everyone. Today, I'm going to show you our next little project activity that you can incorporate in actually all of your projects going forward. We are going to create a producer tag. Now, before I show you a couple different ways on how to create a producer tag and what your options are, keep in mind that you can be as creative as you want. So I found my tag here. Now, there's a lot of different, like I said, there's a lot of different stuff that you can do. The first thing I'm going to show you is on Soundtrap, you can record your tag, and there's a ton of different sound effects that you can use on Soundtrap. So if you want to just record your voice or someone saying whatever your tag might be, keep it school appropriate, you can totally do that. I am going to show you a couple other things that we usually hear in music. So this is my tag.
One, two, three. Get it? OCV.
So you can hear that I have a lot of reverb on that. My name's included in that, OCV. So that's kind of what I did. If you click on edit, you can voice transform. You can go up in pitch. You can put different filters on. So like, let's say I do the baby one just for fun.
One, two, three. Get it? OCV.
So there's a ton of different things that you can do. Let's do robot. Let's see this one.
One, two, three, get it.
It's funny, right? But anyway, so again, you go edit, and then you can even auto-tune something too. And when you click auto-tune, you can, depending on how heavy you want it, you can crank it all the way up to get that more of electronic kind of sound to it. But you can go change pitch. Again, you can make it higher or lower. Voice transform. Again, you can go up in octaves, which are 8 steps. So instead of clicking change pitch by 8 repetitively, you can do that right here. So let's say I go down 2 octaves. Right, crazy. And then, like I said, these are kind of like filters that you can use, so you can check those out as well, okay? So notice how there's nothing else here, right? It's just my tag. And then that way, I can download my tag and drag and drop it in directly into whatever project I'm working on, okay? And I'll show you an example in 1 second. Okay, so I just pulled up one of these podcasts that I did last year, and you can see my tag is on its own track, and it's just a little bit of a beat that I did, and then you can kind of hear my tag, and then this is a podcast, so I have like a intro here, play the whole thing, but the idea is that you can put your producer tag at the beginning of one of your songs so people recognize kind of who the artist is, right? So let's take a little listen. Get the general idea. I'm going to fade out and then I'm going to start talking here. So that just gives you a little bit better of an idea of what you can use this with. Obviously, we see this in songs across the music industry. So this is kind of more of what we're going to be using it for. So that's the first technique. You can just record your voice and then you can alter filters, pitches, auto-tune, whatever you want. The second thing I'm going to show you is text-to-speech. And I'm going to hop over to that website right now. Okay, so here we are in Google, and I can literally just Google search text-to-speech, and there are a ton of different things that come up. Obviously, Google has its own thing. I'm just going to click the first one here. It says naturalreaders.com. It says drag and drop your files or type, paste, and edit text here. So I'm just going to delete this, and I'm gonna type in my idea of a producer tag. Now you can see usually I put OCB together, right? But because this is reading, I actually have to do them separate. Otherwise it doesn't recognize, thinks of it as one word instead of individual letters. So let's hear what that sounds like.
OCV on the beat.
Word. Okay. So I can convert to MP3. I can download it. And again, with that same file, you can drag and drop it directly into whatever project you're working. But yeah, you can type in anything that you want. So this was my original tag, right?
1, 2, 3, get it, OCV.
Right, so I could do that as well if I wanted to kind of change it up a little bit. But again, you just click convert to MP3, take the download, and you drag and drop it directly into your project. The last thing that we're gonna look at, this is getyarn.io. And basically it finds audio clips for you to use. So I'm gonna search in here. I doubt that this will come up. We can see. So it says all of the kind of spelling out the different words, right? So this is probably something that I couldn't use. I probably couldn't use, or if I just did O, right? And then I could kind of piece it together. I could do that too. Let's do something else just so I can kind of show you. Say you have like a producer name. Let's say my producer name is DJ Teacher. So let's look up Teacher. Let's see what we can get. So.
Teacher.
So if I like that, I could download that and then use it as an audio file. So kind of the same thing that we were looking at. And it's not really pronounced, so I'm not going to use that one.
Teacher.
Gotta love South Park. Okay, so let's download this. So all I'm going to do now is save video. Okay, and when I do this, I'm going to save it directly. I could save it right to the desktop. And then I'm going to drag and drop the audio file. Okay, so now that I have my video, I have to export the... By removing the video here, now I just have the audio. I'm gonna rename it, and it might ask me if I want to replace, and I'm gonna click yes because now this is my new version here. So I'm gonna just take this, drag and drop, and now I have my audio. In here. Now I can zoom in so I can get rid of all this space here. Right. Drag this to the beginning.
Teacher.
Now I can do a bunch of different stuff with that. Again, if I want to change the pitch, whatever, if I want to go back to the website and find something that says DJ and put it in, which I will do in a second, I can do that and I will be right back. Okay, so now I found one from the SpongeBob movie, so here we go.
Teacher.
I want these to be a little bit closer. And notice how I don't have them on the same track, right? That's still really important that they're separated, so I can zoom way in.
Teacher.
And I can cut things up here a little bit.
Teacher.
Okay, so now I'm going to kind of fool around with this, transform it a little bit. See what we get here.
Teacher.
Now that kind of messed up the audio, so I don't want that. I want to make sure we have our whole thing. Butter's voice is so bright it barely changed. All right, let's see. Oh yeah, that was the same one. Okay. Let's see if brighter. No. Let's see if darker does anything. Yeah, see? So I'll probably have to keep that the same. Okay, so now I can title this my producer tag. I actually want to make sure this is up a little bit because it's kind of low. There we go. So now when I export homepage producer tag, right? So then I could download this and then I can drag and drop this directly into whatever project I'm working on. Awesome.